winter coats this year, but putting an extra layer on beneath the kids' costumes, definitely something that you'll want to do just because the wind is going to be the biggest issue tomorrow. The wind always makes it feel cooler than it actually is. So let's break down your trick-or-treat forecast right now for you. In Colorado Springs, it is going to be windy tomorrow with wind speeds right around 4 o'clock, between 10 and 15 miles per hour. Temperatures, though, staying in the 50s through 6 o'clock. It won't be until 8 o'clock when temperatures drop into the 40s. So hopefully, as all of the ghouls and goblins are heading indoors, we'll start to see those temperatures dropping after you make it inside. 62 degrees in Pueblo by 4 o'clock tomorrow, 59 at 6. Less wind as we head through the evening with mostly clear skies expected as we head into your Friday night. Canyon City, 61 degrees by 4 o'clock, feeling a bit on the cool side. Lighter winds expected through 6 o'clock with 8 o'clock bringing those cooler temperatures. Woodland Park, 53 degrees to start, but we will be dropping into the 30s as all of the costumed kids are heading inside. So it is going to be a bit chilly, as I mentioned. Throwing an extra layer on beneath the costumes, definitely a great idea. 50s and 60s for your high temperatures tomorrow. We're going to track the wind. The wind will start up during the early afternoon. Strongest winds really going to be across the far eastern plains. That's where we're expecting those speeds to be in the 20s. Along the Front Range, though, expect wind speeds in the teens through about 6 o'clock, and then as we head into the evening hours, the winds are gradually going to subside. Checking out your 7-day forecast as we head into the weekend. Temperatures are warming up. Saturday, 69 degrees. We'll cool down on Sunday. We're going to kick up the wind on Sunday with temperatures, then taking a big fall heading into Monday. We get a cold front that moves through while you're sleeping, and on Monday you're going to wake up to a bit of rain and snow on the Palmer Divide. Could see enough to make for a sloppy drive into work on Monday. We'll be tracking that very closely as we head through the weekend. Temperatures, the big story, though, dropping to 48 degrees. In Pueblo, enjoy the 62 temperature tomorrow and the 70s that we'll see over the weekend, because Monday we're also dropping that temperature in Pueblo to 55 degrees with a 20% chance for rain. We'll dry out, though, and warm up as we head through the remainder of the work week back in the 60s and 70s by next Wednesday and Thursday. In Canyon City, temperatures for your Halloween, not so spooky, 61 degrees, but we will have the wind to contend with. 70-degree temperatures to start off your weekend. We'll hit 66 on Sunday. Sunday will be breezy once again as those cooler temperatures start to head our way. 52 degrees on Monday with that 20% chance for rain in Canyon City. In Teller County and many of the mountain locations, we'll see the showers beginning a bit earlier. They'll fire up Sunday afternoon, and we could see a couple of inches of snow for some of the high country, the higher peaks around Teller County. As I mentioned, we could see, similar to the Palmer Divide, enough snow to make for some sloppy conditions come Monday morning. We'll be watching this storm system very closely because we know very well if it moves a little to the north, we'll get nothing. If it moves farther south, though, it'll put us in the bullseye to get a bit more in the way of rain or snow. So we'll be watching it over the weekend. But most importantly, tomorrow, make sure that all the costumes are secured, because I think the wind will be the biggest issue, dying down, though, as the evening progresses.
But even for the kids trick-or-treating in the mountains, it should be a relatively good night.
Yeah, 50s and 40s during the early trick-or-treat times. And then as the kids are heading home, 30s and 40s, which for this time of year, nothing. Can't